But later on, when the active resistance and armed conflict was near at hand, he took Baya from his companions. I had explained Baya this morning. Come, place your hand here over my hand and pledge that you will listen me and obey me whatever I say. This was such a comprehensive pledge. One of the companions has reported the text of that pledge. Bayana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We pledged ourselves to the Messenger of Allah. Ala sam'i wa ta'a. First of all, we shall listen to whatever you say and obey whatever you say. Fil usri wal yusr. Whether the conditions are easy or bad and difficult, in every case we shall obey. Wal mansate wal makrahe. Whether we feel inclined to do that or we have to force ourselves to do that. وَعَلَىٰ أَسَرَةٍ عَلَيْنَا. Even if you prefer somebody else to us, we shall not say that we were your old companions. How come you have appointed this newcomer young man as our Amir? No, this is your prerogative. You will do, and we shall obey. Whomsoever you put at the helm of affairs, we shall obey him also. And we should not quarrel with them. وَعَلَىٰ نَقُولَ بِالْحَقِّ أَيْنَمَا كُنَّا. But we shall say and present our opinions wherever we would be. We won't be dumb and deaf. We will place our opinion. But it is up to you to decide. Now, I come to the second set of three steps. First I call passive resistance. As I said in my submission in some earlier discourse, that actually the revolutionaries start an offense. The society is there, people are peaceful, all have accepted it as their destiny. Okay, the rich are rich and we poor are poor. Okay. We have to live that way. But someone stands there, it's wrong, it's cruel, it's discriminative, it's oppressive, it's exploitative. So he had started the conflict. The natural reaction, logical reaction from the society and that social order would be to resist it, try to stop it, try to nip the evil, according to them, evil in the bud. The first phase of this was for the first 3 years of his mission. All persecution was focused on the person of Muhammad. Nobody else was persecuted, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it was verbal persecution. You have gone bad. You are majnoon. Some evil spirit has overtaken you, possessed you. They wanted to kill his willpower. But when they saw that this is not successful, people are getting down him. Especially our youth. They have been attracted towards him. And more dangerously, our slaves, they are gathering around him. So now there was the call, guard up your lines and defend your interests. And then started in the fourth year, after the beginning of his dawah, the physical persecution of torturing, keeping the youth bound by chains, keeping them hungry, turning them out from the houses. Go. And especially for the slaves, beat them. Even kill them. One couple was killed after worst persecution and torture. Sumayya and her husband, Yasir. What was done to Bilal? A rope was fastened to his neck and was given to the street urchins. Drag him on the streets of Makkah. And visible the stony streets. And then in the open sun, the sun was sending down fire and he was laid facing sky, the burning ground. And then a rock put on his chest so that he could even not talk. But still he was saying, Ahadun, Ahad, Ahadun, Ahad, Ahadun. I believe in only one God. What happened, for instance, to another companion, Khabab bin al-Arth, radiallahu anhu. He was called. And live cinders, burning coal, they were spread on the ground. And then he was asked to take off your cloth, your shirt, lie down on it. And he lay there. The skin was burnt. Then the fat of the back, that melted. And in this way, the cinders were cooled down. Now the point was, for 8 long years after the beginning of this persecution, physical persecution and torture, the command of the day, order of the day was, take all persecution without any retaliation. You are not allowed to raise your hands, even in self-defense. To this I had given the title, passive resistance. Resistance is here. You have to keep standing on that position. Not going back. Stick to Tawheed. Say that I believe and I will follow Muhammad. You do whatever you like. You want to kill me? Okay, kill me. But no retaliation. This was, I think, the master stroke of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What was the result of this passive resistance? Number one, the revolutionaries have to buy time to be able to reach more and more and more people. In the beginning, they are a few, in very small numbers. If they also reply violence with violence, if they become violent, they will be crushed in no time. So you have to buy time. Taking all persecution, physical and verbal, but not retaliating. Isbiru, isbiru, isbiru. Have patience, have patience, have patience. Be steadfast. Bear it, bear it, bear it. For 8 years, 8 long years, this was the order of the day of Muhammad. The second result was that the silent majority in that city, in that society,